How's it guys? Welcome to Ultimate Exotics. So in today's video, we're going to be doing something really cool, and that is a video on scaleless corn snakes. Now at Ultimate Exotics, we were lucky enough to import South Africa's first scaleless corn snake a few years ago, and we're going to have a look at it today and just teach you a little bit about this recessive mutation so you can understand it a bit better. So let's start off by having a look at our special scaleless corn snake. Okay, so this is our scaleless corn snake that we have had for a few years, and like I said, this was the first one imported into South Africa, and you can see it's just such an incredible looking corn snake. Now, the scaleless mutation, it's a recessive mutation, so it's basically the same as a albino mutation. So you can breed a scaleless corn snake to a normal corn snake, all your babies will come out normal, 100% head scaleless, and then if you breed 100% head scaleless to a scaleless, half the babies will come out scaleless and the other half will be 100% head scaleless, just like we see with the recessive albino mutation. So the scaleless mutation is a recessive. This scaleless corn snake is a silver scaleless corn snake, which is 50% possible head albino. So we've put this to a lot of our girls, and hopefully it's going to make a lot of nice babies this year and in the future as well. So not everyone is a fan of scaleless corn snakes or other scaleless snakes, but there's a few reasons why we feel that there's nothing wrong with this mutation. And one of the reasons being is that although we call it a scaleless corn snake, they are not actually 100% scaleless. They do still have a few scales remaining. You'll see on this one, it has a few scales that you can see coming through here, and it varies between the individuals. Some have more scales than others, but the scales on the body aren't actually that important. The most important thing, and what makes this mutation still okay and not too far out there, is the fact that the snake still has its belly scales. And what's so important about that is that these snakes use these scales to help with their movement, and by still having the scales on their belly, it will allow them to move normally, just like a normal corn snake would. So these snakes live a perfectly normal, happy life in captivity with no ill effects from this mutation whatsoever. The only important thing is that you just got to make sure you don't feed it live prey, because it doesn't have the scales to protect it from a bite from its prey. But that's not a big issue, because most of the time we're all feeding frozen thawed meals anyway. So as long as you're feeding it frozen thawed prey, there's no issues at all. So it basically eats the same, it sheds the same as well. That's what a lot of people ask me. They ask, does a scaleless snake shed? And it sheds exactly like a normal scale, except the shedding looks different. It looks smooth like a balloon, and you won't see all the scales in the shedding like you would see when a normal snake sheds. So as rare as this mutation is, I mean, yeah, you can imagine a scaleless snake, most people don't think it's even real, they think it's a myth. It actually has occurred in other species of snake as well. We've recently seen the scaleless ball python. The gene reacts slightly different in that species, but it's the same concept, a scaleless ball python. I've seen other pictures of scaleless puff adders, and I've also seen pictures of scaleless rattlesnakes. So it is something that does happen from time to time, although it's very rare in the snake world. But with the corn snakes, like I said, I'm not sure how the scaleless gene affects those other species, but with the corn snake, it doesn't affect it in any negative way, which is really great. One thing I love about these scaleless corn snakes is people's reaction when they see them, and I've heard so many different things. Some people will describe it as they feel soft and smooth like marshmallows. Other people say it feels like smooth like human skin. And to be honest, those are quite good comparisons. It is basically the soft, silky feel. And people that, and friends of mine that weren't convinced on this mutation, it's always so great to see the reaction when they see a scaleless corn snake for the first time and get to touch it, because a lot of them, they change their mind. So for those of you that maybe aren't so keen on this morph, before you judge it, wait till you see one, wait till you touch one, and then you can make your decision, because it really is a whole different experience when you hold and touch and even see one of these scaleless corn snakes for your first time. I mean, if you think about it, this is just a silver corn snake, and look at how bright the markings are and how defined all the color and patterning is. So it really enhances the pigment that lies beneath the scale, so you can really just see everything as it is. So in my opinion, you know, the scaleless corn snake, it's hard to not enjoy it. And like I said, if there was any, if the snake suffered in any way from this mutation, we wouldn't be interested in it. But these snakes do not. They live a perfectly normal life in captivity, just like a normal corn snake. And they just have that added beauty to them. So we really enjoy them, and we hope we can make lots more of these scaleless corn snakes in the future for those that are interested in them.
As I mentioned earlier, the one question that I get asked the most with regards to the scaleless corn snakes is, do they shed? And yes, they do shed just like a normal corn snake. And they shed all in one piece. They don't have a broken up shed. They shed perfectly normal, just like a normal corn snake would. And just in comparison, you can see the difference of the shed here. So this shed at the bottom is the shed from the scaleless corn snake. And like I said, you can see it's just smooth like a balloon. And then because there's obviously no scales, so there's no scale markings in that, but you can see the ventral scales of the shed there like a normal shed. And then this is just in contrast, a shedding from another snake where you can clearly see all the scales marked there. So the shed is exactly the same. It just doesn't have the pattern of the scales on the shed. The one thing that I find so amazing about these scaleless corn snakes, like we were talking about earlier, is the pigment that comes through from the pattern that lies beneath the scales. Now that there's no scales, you can see it. And it's just amazing how bright it is and how defined it is. But you can see on this scaleless corn snake, you know, the skin there, see how it's wrinkled there where it turns. And then here, like we saw earlier, you can see there's a few scales over there. And it just gives them such an incredible pattern. And like I said, this is just a silver corn snake, but just look at how bright and defined its markings are. And then you can see on its head as well, there's no scales. And you can see his ventral scales on the side there, lying in perfect movement. But yeah, it is just an incredible feeling being able to hold one of these snakes. They just feel so awesome. And I think, in my personal opinion, they're actually just such a special mutation. That's really exciting.
Alright guys, so I hope I cleared up some questions there, and I hope you better understand the scaleless mutation in corn snakes. As you can see, it's just such a beautiful mutation, and yeah, I hope this video has helped you understand it a little bit better so you can make your mind up about it. But yeah, thanks very much for watching this video. Please leave a comment below, hit that like button, and please, most importantly, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video. Keep well. Cheers.